Forget the white wine. Forget the therapy. Do a little tap dancing. And maybe if you want to pick your spirits up a little. Thought I was gonna be lousy, didn't you? Maybe a little time step? It's the only way to feel good. It's the best way to feel good. Then someday, the big curtain goes up and every seat in the house is filled. And they're cheering you. This is what happened to the tap dancing class under the direction of today's guest in a movie that is now playing your local theater. Ladies and gentlemen, here's that teacher, Academy Award winning Liza Minnelli, right here. Come over here. We're already crazy about this. Look at, thank you. Here's, hang on 1 second. Took your first lesson when you were probably what, 2, 3?
About 4, but I never learned to tap until this movie.
Well, boy, it doesn't look it. I'll tell you, you look like a pro, like you've been doing this.
But you're great at this. Look at you. This is so
well,
funny.
Well, I'm showing off.
It's hard to do that even. Usually people say,
I want to show you four. You were 4 here. Show them, Brian. Ta-da.
Oh.
Are you gorgeous there or what? Look at there. And this is the first time that you've, cabaret, you won the Academy Award. That wasn't tap dancing?
No.
It was jazz. I see.
Basically.
I see.
Fosse had a whole different style. You don't know what to call it except Fosse dancing, you know.
And you of course, have high heels on.
I have shoes that are ludicrous. Pain, I have.
Well, why don't you be seated right here?
Yes, sir.
And I want to show them, let me show them a clip of this, now that I've exhausted my talent as a tap dancer. Here is Liza with a dance. The movie is titled Stepping Out. These are people, 2 left feet. I'd fit into this movie. This may be the one movie I would work in. Here you are doing your best as they approach Lincoln Center, where amateur groups are going to perform, and they are scared to death, and you'll see why in just a moment. I don't know how many, just hours to the opening. Watch this. At rehearsal. 'Stepping out.' I'm sure you'll bring that enthusiasm to a ticket to this movie about which you must be very proud. Not only making movies, but Radio City Music Hall.
Oh, yes.
You work for a living, kid.
Thank you.
So you're still excited then by the big concert when the curtain is closed before the show and you hear all those people.
Oh,
through the
sure.
Curtain. You like that?
Oh, I love that. I think what I liked so much about Stepping Out was the fact that it's about these, you know, these people, and we're really terrible. I'm an ex-Broadway dancer. That's my part that I play. And I have this class, and everybody's basically klutzy. But we get challenged, and it's to a small benefit, you know? It's just a little local show in Buffalo, New York. But it becomes these people's whole lives. And through tap dancing and through music and through having a team effort, they solve some of their other problems, too, because it's about support and friendship and that stuff. And it's such a brilliant cast. It's such a brilliant cast. It's really good. I must say, it's, and I don't say that very often.
Well,
I didn't tell you this about Rent-A-Cop.
I'll tell you what.
You know, I never said it.
You know what's marvelous about the people who support your effort in this ensemble of in this movie is they are so perfectly bad and so perfectly good down
yes.
at the end. Now, no small trick.
No, it's very difficult to do that. They're wonderful.
Her mother is Judy Garland and her father, Vincent Minnelli. Both her parents divorced when she was 1951 when she was five. And yes, she has. Her sister is Lorna Luft, her brother Joseph. And the new film is titled Stepping Out, and you can ask her anything you wish, and we'll give you that opportunity as we guest with Liza Minnelli in New York City in just a moment.
I can't believe this report is due this afternoon.
What is that?
Craft-free Italian.
You carry Italian dressing in your purse.
Hey, I love Italian.
Obviously.
You want some?
No, thank you. No, it's too much fat.
Oh, no, this is craft-free. See, fat-free, cholesterol-free.
It sounds great.
Just try it.
Mmm. Craft-free Italian non-fat dressing. If it tastes too good to be fat-free, it's craft-free.
Wonder if they make ranch.
Mm.
But they do.
Have you had it up to here with frying? Shake and Bake makes crisp, juicy chicken your whole family will love. Why fry? Shake and Bake.
The fresher the vegetable, the fresher the salad. And now there's a fat-free dressing that tastes just as fresh. New Good Seasons for fat-free dressing. The fat-free you make fresh with no oil. Because the best fat-free is the fresh fat-free.
Ford's One Price program makes buying a new 93 Escort LX easy because the three-door, four-door, five-door, and wagon with air, AM, FM, stereo, and more are all just one low price. You just decide on your favorite. And that's so easy, even a child could do it. Good choice, Bob.
One Price Escort is a whole new way to buy. Choose three-door, four-door, five-door, or wagon, all popularly equipped and all just $10,499 at your New England Ford dealer.
Give me the gun.
It's Jordan Marsh Stock Up Sale.
Savings.
Buys, reductions, store-wide.
Like 25% off the new Mrs. Jeanswear.
Even Bill Glass.
These Mrs. and Junior Leathers.
$179.
These Life Stride Pumps in Flat.
$29.99.
And $39.50 Pinpoint Cotton Shirts.
$29.99.
That $200 Juice Man Junior.
$149.
Just what you need for fall.
Check out the Jordan Marsh Savings and Stock Up.
Now through Tuesday.
Jordan Marsh Stock Up Sale. Store-wide.
Terrific.
I'm a big fan of
You're a big fan of who?
I'm a big fan of the Arthur movies. I was just wondering if you're like planning on like
doing
another film with Dudley Moore in the future.
I would love to do another film with Dudley Moore. He's absolutely best to work with and so funny. There hasn't been any plans for one though.
Hi, is it Andrea Martin I see in the commercials that's with you in this movie?
Yes, and she is terrific.
How do you keep a straight face with that woman?
We couldn't.
I mean,
between Shelley
She's
Winters,
so
Andrea Martin, Robin Stevens, Sheila McCarthy, Bill Irwin, it's just amazing.
Shelley Winters is the pianist for this crowd. Yes.
I teach tap dancing. I was wondering how long it took you to learn how to tap dance for the movie.
Well, we rehearsed, all of us, and
I thought
us
she'd
did.
Never get it, but I have a lot of patience.
Hey, you're fine.
No, none of us could really tap dance. A lot of us could dance, but not tap dance. We rehearsed about 5 weeks, 8 hours a day, 6 days a week, and let me tell you, bleeding feet will bond you guys. It's all women, the whole class, except for one man, played by Bill Irwin, who is, you know, so wonderful. And it was the happiest experience I ever had.
Well, you who cannot tap dance, we should all be so challenged, because here you are in a solo from this movie. I want to show this off. Now, here's the way we all ought to move. Here's your basic next-door neighbor. Doing her exercises in the morning. Watch this. I don't know. I don't know how you did this part. And I assume you had a chiropractor on the set.
Yeah.
Was certainly that wasn't one take genius, or was it?
No, it wasn't. The challenge of that number, it's, you know, in doing a musical today, you have to make each number really a scene. Actually, my father told me that when I was little, that the musical number has to further the story. So in that particular number, the character I play is down on her luck. She's angry. She's frustrated. She's lost her place in her own life. And just through dancing, she gets it back again. She remembers who she is. So it helps the story along. So that's why it was choreographed like that.
Liza, first of all, I want to say that you're absolutely amazing. You move like you're in a dream sequence. It's not even real. But what I want to know is, how did you manage to get yourself started to begin with? What forced you to want to become a dancer? What, you know, motivated you?
Well, when I was little, my parents both worked at MGM, right? And I would go there to visit them after school. And it was really boring watching, like, movies being done, because it's tedious. They do close-ups, and then they do over the shoulders. And so watching any of the acting was dull. But I found my way into the rehearsal halls so I could watch Gene Kelly. And I could watch, and it was this high, you know, I could watch Sid Charisse, and I could watch these people moving. And that attracted me, the movement and the energy and the music. And it looked so joyful. And they looked like they were having such a good time.
Here you are, pardon me, Liza, with your mom at age, what hour is it? in the good old summertime. So you're what, 4 or 5 here? You were in the film.
Yeah, 4, huh? Right. So everything since then is a comeback.
Right. So you were surrounded then by But you're very honest to say, to a kid, this was boring. It's tedious. The take, stop, action, start, fix the set, sit in the dressing room.
Right.
Boring, yeah. It's amazing. So I wonder you didn't get turned off altogether.
But then I wanted to be an ice skater. But then I saw Bye Bye Birdie. I came to New York with my parents, and I saw those kids up there dancing, and I thought, oh, no, wait a minute. Maybe that's what I really want to do. Maybe that's what I really want to do.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Liza, I was wondering, you used to not sing your mother's music, and lately you have begun doing some of her pieces. What is the reason for that?
Well, actually, I haven't. It's so funny, but I get annoyed if I hear anybody else singing her songs. It makes me crazy. I think it does. I mean, she sang it so brilliantly. It's just the second best version to me. And the one great lesson she taught me, I think, besides many great lessons, was always try and be a first-rate version of yourself as opposed to a second-rate version of somebody else. So I remember that.
before Cabaret, I wasn't sure how I felt about you. You were, you know, somebody's daughter, you know? That's but cool. When you did Cabaret, you were fabulous. Really fabulous.
Yeah, thank you.
I just want to know, how did you get the part, and how many other women did you beat for that part?
Well, it's an odd story, because originally when it was conceived for Broadway, for a while I was considered for the role, and then I lost the role. And then when they made the film, I just petitioned for it. I just kept going back and saying, I think I can do this, and I really want to do it. I fought for it, you know, because it was such a good part.
Is dancing one of those things that's really born in you, or can you come back as an adult and try to take this up?
I think it's how it affects you emotionally. Do you know what I mean? I mean, if you find yourself even as a kid, or if any of us are standing around and you hear music and it moves you and it causes you to move, I think you can dance anytime you want to in your life.
We do have little peaks at Cabaret. Liza and those who are responsible for the hard work that went into this fascinating movie titled Steppin' Out would not be displeased if I showed you other clips of that movie as well, which we will do. I'm also pleased to tell you that Liza will sing for us before the end of our film. Yeah. Assuming we have enough time after I finish my number. Hi.
What was it like growing up with your wonderful mother?
It was terrific. And it's always hard for me. I know that it's hard for other people to understand that it was normal, because it always sounds so glamorous, but everybody else's family was famous too. Do you know what I mean? All of my childhood friends, everybody went to the same factory, so everybody's parents were equally as famous, so there was no basis for comparison. So we weren't isolated, and we didn't feel special, and we didn't, you know, get all snobby and everything, because everybody was in the same boat. But it was extraordinary growing up with that kind of wit and intelligence and humor. It was great.
You must be at least somewhat aghast at the number of Mommy Dearest books now. I mean, everybody got... and you're what? Pleased to step forward and say there is no such book in you, and would be no evidence for anything like this.
Burt Reynolds gave me a great compliment. He's a good friend, and he gave me something I really treasure. He said, she loved her parents before it was popular. You know.
About you.
Mm-hmm. So I remember that.
Now. Oh. Well, now, what parent wouldn't like that said about their child? How did your mom do it? Now, for those guilty working women out there.
Yes.
Your mother was on the road a lot. I assume there was shooting in Europe, England, and other places.
Sure.
And you grew up without any feeling of, oh, where is she? She did, you know, you don't even seem to have an innocent, analytical longing for the possibility that your mother wasn't there at every moment. How did you and your mother work that out? Because you had to write that book.
We went with her.
Yeah.
She would, you know, she gave us the choice. My sister Lorna, my brother Joe, and myself, she sat us down and said, look, I got to go to work because we got to eat. And we have no money. And I can do it if I do concerts. I can make money. But it means we're going to have to travel. So I want you to sit down with each other and really think about this. You can go with me, or you can stay here and stay in school, and it can be normal, and I'll get back here every chance I can. But really talk about it together and think about it. And we talked about it and everything. And then the three of us just walked in the room and said, when do we leave? You know?
And we'll be back in just a moment. Two Tonys on Broadway for performances in Flora, The Red Menace, and The Act, as well as a special Tony in 1974. And you know her also as the Oscar winner for her performance in Cabaret. I ask you now to enjoy as this remarkably talented woman shares with us from her movie, Stepping Out, the title song, Stepping Out, Miss Minnelli.
I just have a question for you. Since you started out in the business so at an early age, did you find yourself faced with any of the issues that our young people today in show business are faced with?
Like?
Drugs or?
Oh, sure. Okay. Everything. Yes. You know, and the funny thing is that you can't, no matter how much people give you advice or you read about stuff and everything, if advice counted, none of us would have a problem. You know, we'd... It doesn't work. You've got to go through it yourself and find your own way out of your own problems, you know, and finally see a light at the end of the tunnel and it's not another train, you know.
You're, since your own decision to check into Betty Ford,
sure.
Since that experience, one of the points you made, you're not tired all the time.
No, well, I was the kind of person that never fell down. I never missed work. I never did any of the things that you think of when you think of somebody being a real mess. But inside, I felt so weird, you know. And it was like I thought I had some kind of blood disease. And it had snuck up on me so fast, I mean, so slowly, that when it really hit me, I was doing a Broadway show called The Rink. And I turned to a friend of mine and I said, I think I'm going to die. And they laughed. And I said, no, I really, there's something wrong with me. And I don't know what it is. But I feel sick and tired all the time. And I don't like it. So when I found out exactly what I could do to fix it, it was such an incredible relief. It was like somebody handing you your life back, you know? And just, I think you have to feel like that in order to make big changes. And if anybody tells you that nothing changes, tell them to just go do whatever. Things change, you know?
Now, does this mean no white wine?
Oh.
Nothing.
No, I am allergic to any kind of mood-altering drug. And wine or alcohol is that. And that's the reality. And if you got the reality, you got the facts, then you can work your whole life around them.
Right.
You know?
Now when you walk into a crowded room with all the bzz, 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 right. Some of the things we hear from those who have chosen sobriety.
Yes.
Include, first of all, people who drink talk loud.
Well,
people who drink, is it a problem? Are you a square in a round hole? We're thrilled at your decision. Who wouldn't be? Shouldn't we all make it? But I'm curious to know about the consequence of this new way of life as you present in normal social situations now. You're one of the few in the room that isn't drinking.
Well, because I can't. And I only speak for myself.
But you know, is it fun to be there? Is it difficult to connect, is the question.
When you have at first, but I had some really good advice. And like, you see, it's all a matter of planning ahead. You go to a party, you know you're going to be uncomfortable. At about what time do people start getting a little bit, start repeating the stories and that, start getting a little loose? If there's a cocktail hour, you skip that. You arrive right before dinner. And then afterwards, you wait until that first time somebody says, did I tell you about? And then you say, gee, many Christmas, the drapes are on fire, I gotta go. And you leave.
We're in New York City with Liza Minnelli, and we'll be back in just a moment.
You're a terrific entertainer, but what role or movie have you enjoyed the most?
Oh, gosh.
Role or movie? You mean stage or movie?
Anything. What have you enjoyed doing the most?
Stage? Movie? Honestly, and it's not because this is happening right now in my life, I had the best time I ever had making Stepping Out, maybe because of the cast, because of the feeling on the set. But that, I think, I enjoyed the most. That and Radio City.
Over here.
Talking about changes in people's lives, are there any babies in the future?
Oh, God, wouldn't that be great?
Yes.
Wouldn't that be something?
Is there anyone you haven't worked with that you'd like to in the future?
Everybody. Do you know what I mean? There's so many talented people and so many good directors, and I want to do everything. I don't have many wishes. I'd like to do everything.
Yeah, I have a very simple question. Because I'm a hairdresser in New York, I have a hair salon, so I make money off the Liza style. I want to know, what am I doing? I'm from Israel. I don't know. It's like Liza style. I have a client.
No.
Tell them
a little
about it.
It's just easier, you know?
No. Easier. In other words, there's nothing particularly...
No, you just go, you know? It's not a lot of... Yeah.
Hi, Liza, you're the greatest in the whole world. Can we please get you in a recording studio and get more albums out of you?
Yes.
There's never enough.
Yes. Thank you.
I was
wondering what it was like to have worked with Sammy Davis Jr.
I'm sorry.
I was wondering what it was like to have worked with Sammy Davis Jr.
Oh, that was spectacular. He was so intelligent and so bright and so well-read. Plus, he was the antithesis of American show business because he did everything. And he could segue, and he was at home on a stage. I always thought I had to rehearse until I dropped. I still do feel that way, to get comfortable. He could get up and ad lib, you know, and then he could talk to you about world affairs, and then he was just probably the smartest and the kindest man I ever knew.
I just want to say you've always been gorgeous, but you're stunning. You're beautiful. Yeah. Something is so different. I mean, you're beautiful. I just have to tell you that. What have you been doing? You're gorgeous.
Well, I eat well. I take care of myself. Oh, thank you. Well, you do, Eliza. You look well, and it's certainly visible on the screen in Stepping Out. Here is this merry band of tap dancers who begin the movie with two left feet, and now they're at Lincoln Center.
It's a theater in Buffalo, New York. Right, it's a little theater.
Well, it's not so
little. The Elgin Theater.
Right, but they had no idea. They're behind this curtain.
Wait, don't tell them.
All right. Watch this. Watch this. Finally, they got to the place where they're nervous about.
Hello, Mavis Turner Tappers. Can you show me what you got on this front pipe?
You got it, babe.
You got any specials?
Yeah.
Can I use them?
No, they're all sent for Miss Leichner.
Well, look, just light us so you can see us. Okay, everybody. Here we go. Opening positions. Oh, sorry, Max. Now, yeah, here, hats up. All right, just back up just a little bit.
I've worked with Andrea Martin in Toronto. Do you have any future projects set up with her?
Oh, I would love to do that.
Any future films? Is she fabulous?
She's fantastic. And we all had such a good time working together. We keep trying to find things now where we can do things together, where we can all work together again. Maybe they'll make a sequel to this. Wouldn't that be good?
Over here, please.
Yes. I was just wondering what you preferred, the big screen making the movies or being live on Broadway, and if there's any future plans for a musical.
I don't have plans for a musical. I'm going back to Radio City at the end of January, and I really like working on film. I think it's taken me time to understand how to do it. You know, I really enjoy it now.
Yes. You've done so much. Results was a wonderful album.
Thank you. You've changed over the years.
What's next for you?
What's next?
I don't know. That's what's so cool, you know? I just don't know, and it gets me excited every morning. I have no idea what's going to happen to me, and I love it.
Did you tape at the Shays in Buffalo, and why did you pick Buffalo?
Actually, we filmed the movie in Toronto. It's supposed to take place in Buffalo, but it was filmed in Toronto.
And then they refer to the Center for the Performing Arts, I think, in the film.
Yes, exactly. That's what it was like.
Yeah. I would like to know if you trained as an actor, or do you always just follow your instincts?
No, I went to Herbert Berghoff and Uta Hagen's school and studied with Uta and studied with Charles Nelson Reilly for musical comedy.
Oh, God.
And I worked hard. I studied quite a bit.
Hi, Liza. I think your mother was terrific.
And I take a show that you and the two of you did together on Channel 13. And I would just like to know, how did you like working with your mother?
Oh, it was wonderful. It was scary, but it was wonderful. I figured once you worked with my mother, you can work with anyone. You know, nobody ever scared me since then.
Do I? let me ask you about... was the Palladium not a kind of... Little Liza's no longer little, and if I understand your mother's response to seeing you work right next to her on the stage of the Palladium, you scared the hell out of her. In the sense that she said, holy cow, she is good. Do I have this right? Isn't that what she essentially said?
Yeah, it was like we went through in 2 hours. Life was always speeded up in my family. We went through in 2 hours what most mothers and daughters go through for years, which was that sense of, wait a minute, you know, this competition here. And it was funny because when that show started, I'd never done anything. I didn't really know why she wanted me there, but she did want me there, and so I went. And I thought, well, I'll sing this and I'll do this, and I had nothing to lose, so I had no fear. She was the one who was nervous. So it starts out, and I hear her say, ladies and gentlemen, Liza Minnelli, with a great, proud voice. And I come on, and I sing, and the audience really likes it. And I hear her backstage going, yeah, baby, go, yeah, baby. Then I sing the second song, and there's more applause. She says, yeah. I thought, keep going, Minnelli, keep going. By the fourth song, I just glanced in the wings and said, can I stand up for a minute? And she was going, okay. okay. Now, my mother walked off the stage. Judy Garland walked back on the stage. It was like, and it was like competition, but with enormous love, but with this sense of, I'm dealing with a power out here. From both of us. You know, it was extraordinary.
You must be proud of your mother for saying this out loud.
Oh, yeah.
She talked about this.
She talked about everything. You know, she did. Mm-hmm. And she taught us to do that. Mm.
Before you were her daughter and okay, and then on that, at that moment on the stage of the Palladium, what a story this is.
Yeah, no.
She says, holy cow, she is good. Isn't that interesting?
Because she was... And I was 17, so she was proud, but there must have been that threat at the same time. And I, like I said, I had nothing to lose, so I could, you know, it was terribly funny at the end, because we walked off the stage together, and she said, great, baby, that was just great. And she patted my behind, she said, I'll see you in the dressing room. And I started to walk, and I turned around in time to see her running back out on stage for another bow, and I went, no, you don't. And I went right with her.
And we'll be back with Liza Minnelli. Yes,
Liza, with your great fame and great success, you seem to be a very down-to-earth and humble person. And yes. I'd like to ask you another question. Have you achieved all your goals in life? Do you want to do anything else other than what you have done?
Nah, yeah. She just wants to go sit down on the rocker and...
No, and I keep finding new ones. You know, I try not to set ones that are really hard. I really try and go one day at a time, you know.
Hi, Liza. You seem close to your family growing up. I was wondering if you ever keep in touch with your sister, Lorna.
Oh, yes.
Socialize with her a lot?
Oh, yes. My sister, Lorna, is my best friend and makes me laugh harder than anyone.
Liza, you said that you had to work really hard to get your role in Cabaret.
Yeah.
Do the roles come easier, or do you have to work just as hard now?
I think you still have to work as hard. Life is one long audition, you know? It's because... that's the way it works.
Yes. Liza, first of all, I think you're absolutely adorable.
Thank you.
Refreshing. But I must tell you, nobody that I've ever heard sang New York, New York like you sing it. Heard a song since that moved me like Stepping Out. Who wrote that?
It was written by the people who wrote New York, New York. Brad Aaron and John Cantor.
We had just seen a clip of a music video you did, Losing My Mind. Yeah. That was such a departure in our minds from what you usually do, and we loved it. Are we going to have more of that?
Yes. You know, I would love to figure out a way to marry all kinds of music together, and I'm trying to work that out now. So that there's kind of a thread to put it on a record, so that there's everything that you love on one record. I don't know if I can do it, but maybe I can.
You can.
Oh. Yeah.
Hi. What do you think is, how do you feel about working with Frank Sinatra?
Oh, that was swell. Wait, how would you feel about it? I felt exactly like you did. You know what? I was just as stunned as you were. I really was. But imagine standing up there next to that man when he's singing, you know, I've got you under my skin. Okay.
You mentioned that your mother had to sing to eat, to eat. It may be lost on some of us as we think about your rather glamorous childhood, surrounded as you were by all these stars when movie stars were royalty. But your mother, and your mother was divorced when you were five. So I guess you knew this. You must bring some middle-class fear in your head to your own adult life. I don't know, do you?
I've never felt, absolutely, yeah. Terrible fears about being broken, and I'm much too much of a people pleaser, and I have stuff I work on. I have stuff I work on, try and get better at. But I know one thing, and the thing that comforts me about it is that I know that everybody who's sitting here and almost everybody I've ever met has gone through the same kind of fears or anxieties. I'm not by myself.
Now, when you say fears and anxieties, let me just take a moment. Uh-huh. People pleaser. There's a point where you realize there's a line where you're trying too hard. I mean,
yes.
A lot of us
sure.
do.
Sure, yeah.
So enjoy pleasing people, but you don't have to jump out of a cake for everybody.
Well, yeah, exactly. And there's the only word that is in every single language is no. You know, and it's a whole thought. No, I'm tired. No, I don't want to. No, thank you very much, but I'd rather not. And that was hard for me to learn how to say.
And we'll be back in a moment. Really scares me. I'm starting to understand these videos.
Yes. Sorry. How you doing, Liza? Have you ever done a video or done a film that you was found to be displeasing?
Yes. It never started out that way. You know, we all had high hopes, but I think that Burt Reynolds, who's such a great friend of mine, and I were disappointed in the results of Rent-A-Cop. And I think that Dudley and I, who's another great friend of mine, we tried really hard. But for some reason, Arthur 2 was nowhere near Arthur 1, you know.
Liza, do you still get butterflies? And if so, how do you deal with them?
I pray. I do. And I take a deep breath. That's the only thing I can think of to do. And then I tell my feet to go. Go, you know.
When you were on tour with Sammy Davis Jr., did you notice if he was ill or anything towards the end or... No.
No. Uh-huh. He was excellent.
Yes.
He was in great voice right up until he found... He just suddenly one day went... He said, I can't clear my throat. And that was like 3 months before he died. It was really frightening.
Yes.
Your life's had a lot of highs and lows. What's your high point?
Today.
Liza, you have a dynamite body, and yeah. I was dynamite body. It's unbelievable. And I was wondering, how was it working with Robert De Niro in New York, New York?
Dynamite.
And we'll be back with the dynamite body in just a moment. Stepping out stars Liza Minnelli. Yes.
Liza, you're a wonderful compliment to both of you.
Both her parents.
Both of your parents. Yeah. You're just a wonderful compliment to both of them. I wonder if you could say either one of them were stronger as a parent influence on your life.
Services provided and promotional fees.